Earliest human artifacts show that dogs have always served as man's best friend. So why not draw some? Welcome everybody to the Art Workshop. I am Christopher Epling, your host. I'd like to thank you for tuning in today. And as the intro kind of suggested, we are looking at today at drawing dogs, believe it or not. So we've looked, you know, in the past at humans and different forms and shapes and actions and emotions. And I got to thinking in preparation for this video, why not draw or learn how to draw some dogs? Now, since we don't have a ton of time in our show, we're going to have to kind of be a little the choices we make are going to have to be a little deliberate here because dogs in cartoons and comics and across the board with illustrations appear in all sorts of different ways and different forms and fashions. I bet right now if I say to you, name a cartoon dog, you could do it pretty easy. Some of the most famous come to mind are I think, Goofy. There's also Courage the Cowardly Dog. There's Odie from Garfield, and that's just to name a few. There's even Cat Dog, which is a dog and a cat combined. So there's a lot of stuff out there. I've learned more and more about different types of cartoon dogs and comics and illustrations and cartoons from visiting tons of schools and talking to students. And whenever I ask students, hey, what would you like, you know, for me to draw for you at the end of a presentation, oftentimes hands go up and, you know, cartoon dogs come up as being one of those things. So today we're going to learn how to do three different types of characters, cartoon dogs, in different settings. And I hope you grab some pencil, some paper. You'll need an eraser for this show, of course, too, because we always make mistakes. And as soon as you have those things, you can follow along with me right there at home. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into today's episode. Of course, paper is essential, and we do have our paper ready, and we're ready to begin. And so I want everybody at home to remember that we use a circle method, and we've talked about this before in the art workshop, where we'll plan out our drawing ahead of time. And when we do plan out our drawing ahead of time, we want to be careful not to press down too hard with our pencil. There's going to be a lot of erasing at the end. Now, there's one other item that you're going to need for today's show, and that's an ink pen or Sharpie, something with a fine tip on it, not a really thick tip like a marker. So I'm talking more of a pen or a felt pen. You may want to go ahead and grab that too, because at the end, after we finish actually sketching out the drawing, we're going to go back and we're going to ink it. And basically what that means is tracing over our lines, okay? So the first thing that we're going to be working on today is actually going to be a cartoon dog that we mentioned at the beginning of the show, who is Odie from Garfield. He's really well known. Everyone knows this character. So we'll go ahead and get started, okay? So the first thing that you're going to want to do is get your paper. You're going to line it what we call portrait. Now, portrait is where you have your paper straight up and down like this, long ways is going from top to bottom, okay? And what we're going to do is go ahead and use what we call the circle method, and we're going to draw a circle right in the middle of the paper. This is going to serve as Odie's head, okay? So we have our circle there, and we're ready now to go ahead and start putting in the detail. For the body, Odie has a really wide and usually open mouth, so we want to try to remember that as we're moving forward, and the mouth will come down this way. So all you gotta do is draw another shape, which is going to be a small thin oval, which will go right below your circle. So these two shapes now that we have, we've combined those, and those will eventually become Odie's head and his mouth. His ears will be up here above the top of the circle. The next shape we're actually going to do is a smaller circle. Odie has a very small body compared to his mouth. And the creator of Garfield actually did that purposefully. It shows more animation to the character, even though we're looking at a 2D image. One more circle to join that one. So now we've got a total of three circles, two small, one large, and an oval. All these shapes are going to combine in order to create the cartoon character Odie. Odie has giant feet, so let's go ahead and put those at the bottom. Before you draw the feet, let's draw the legs. On these two ovals at the front, we want to go ahead and put those close together. And if you notice, it's sort of almost turning into what looks like a balloon dog. Like if you went to a carnival, and you ask, you got one of the balloon dogs where they take the balloons and they twist them. That's exactly what this is shaping up to look like, and that's what we want. Okay, so we're going to draw the other circle here and one more here below. So, and we have the back feet, which will be here, and one more behind it. Okay, all right. So now we're going to go ahead and go back up to the top to the first circle that we started with, and we're going to start putting in the detail for Odie's ears and his eyes and nose and mouth. So let's go back up to the top, and so this bottom line that you have that goes around the bottom of the circle is actually going to end up forming the dog's mouth, or the top part of his mouth, okay? So what you're going to do is you're going to follow this line around to a certain point, and then you're going to make a line coming in, go back around this way, and make a line coming in here, okay? Both sides, just like that. Once you have that, then you can start forming the shapes that you need for his mouth and his eyes and things for his head, okay? So we're going to do the letter C. It looks like the letter C right here, so you can see it there. And then on the other side, the same thing. On both sides of where we came in with our lines at the bottom of this circle. See how that works? So we traced around the bottom of the circle, made a line coming in, made a line coming in here, and then we did the C shape here and another backward C shape there. Okay? Now once we have those two elements drawn, what we could do is go ahead and start working on his nose. Drawing a center line up the middle of this circle will help you to show you exactly where the middle of Odie's face is. So it goes all the way up like that. Okay, we want to come up from the bottom of this circle about to right here where the oval stops. This oval is what I'm talking about. And we're going to go ahead and put the nose on there. He's got a pretty big nose in relation to his body. Not oversized, but it's fairly big. So we're going to draw a small oval right there. Okay, once we have that, then we can begin work on his eyes. Now his eyes are actually shaped with two ovals, and they're split right down the middle. So you can go ahead and draw half an oval on this side of your line coming up, and half a oval on this side with the line coming down this way. So this is what we're going to be left with here in a second. We'll have the general shape for his eyes. Both Garfield and Odie here have similar shapes to their eyes, okay? Now once we have that, we can actually go ahead and put the pupils in. The pupils are very small, and they're centered down towards the bottom of the eyes and on each side of the line separating the top circle, okay? Now we've got the formation of the eyes, and that's exactly what we need now to be able to draw the ears. The ears rest just right on top of the dog's eyes, and the center line for the ears splitting is actually this line here that we've drawn going straight up the circle. So go back up to the top there where you've left off and go ahead and draw the shape coming up this way and the shape coming up this way. Now these two lines that have come up from the center point of this line separating the eyes are going to form the two lines of the backside of the ears. And what I mean by that is this line is going to come up to this point, and then you're going to draw, guess what, another oval just hanging like this, like an olive on a branch hanging off right there. And on this side, another oval, same thing, kind of looks like an olive or a grape hanging on a grapevine. So here's our grape, here's our vine, here's our grape, there's our vine, see? So we're going to draw our oval here and an oval here. Once we have those two things, what we could do is we go back now up underneath, actually, and we're going to connect the ears down. See how that works? So now we have Odie's ears. Using these shapes really help. Looking at a drawing and trying to draw something by freehand, or guessing where lines and how lines connect, the distance between, let's say, you know, the ear and the eye, and those things are difficult to do. But if you draw these shapes in first, what we call the circle method, it really helps you to get an idea of what relation one line or shape is to another on a drawing. Now we're going to focus on his mouth. We're going to come down. You see this line that we created right here that went straight up this circle? Remember our old circle that we had a long time ago before it started looking like a face? This circle here had this straight line going down. We want to continue with that line going straight down, and we're going to stop about where the dog's body is. So we've got these circles for the dog's body. So we're going to make a little hash mark right there, and that's going to represent the bottom of his mouth, okay? We're going to go back up to underneath our circle or the face, and we're going to draw two lines coming down to meet where we've sealed off for the mouth right here. So on both sides, these two lines come straight down to this line here, all right? And that forms his mouth. Now, all of this in a little while will be darkened in, this entire area here, all the way down to about right here, okay? We're not going to worry about the tongue yet. Odie's well known in all the comics that I've ever seen. Remember growing up, he has this giant tongue that's always lapping and bothering Garfield and trying to eat his food and all that. So we're going to leave that and save that for last. So what I need you to do, though, is to go back where you've made these two lines coming down, and you're going to make another line, a parallel line. And remember we talked about parallel lines in a separate show. Parallel lines are two lines that run close to one another, but they never cross. So what you're doing is drawing an exact shape that you drawn earlier, just following the line that you made earlier on both sides, here and here, coming down, okay? Now once you have that, you're going to return back over here to this line, not this line, but this line that's on the left side of the mouth, and you're actually going to bring it down like this, and you're going to wrap it right there. See what I've done? So it goes down and in. Notice I'm not crossing over this oval yet because I need that oval here in a second whenever I actually go to finish the body. Now let's go back to this line, the right side of the mouth. And on that one, what we're going to do is we're going to draw a little hump shape here, one of them there, and then we're going to do another one right here. This one's larger, and this one actually comes up and down just like that, okay? So you see what I've done? I've drawn an upside down letter C, and then this shape that follows our circle that we drew for this back part of the body. So it just follows that circle down, and then an upside down letter C there, okay? Once we have those two shapes, we can go ahead and draw a line coming across for his body, underneath his belly, which will be this line here. Now we need to focus on the legs. Now for the legs, it's pretty simple, but you have to watch because one of these shapes gets out of order, it won't look exactly the way mine does. So on your paper, what I need you to do is to make, again, the letter C right here. A letter C coming down like this, and then a straight line down like that. Okay, so we've got the letter C and a straight line. And then behind this, though, I need you to come up, actually, up like this and down. So this forms the back leg. Okay, this forms the back leg of the dog. And this is the dog's knee, supposedly, okay? So you got the knee, and here's the back part of the leg, and comes down to the foot. On the front part, this is really easy. All this is two straight lines, and they are slightly parallel, but they do fan out at the bottom. So that means they start pretty close together here at the top, and as they get further down towards the foot, they spread apart, okay? Very slightly, not very much, but they do. Here and here, just like that. On the back side, you don't really have to worry about anything. You just sort of follow this line parallel to make a line in the back. Same thing for the back of the leg here, too. You're drawing a parallel line straight down following the line in the back, okay? Now, once you have, and I've colored this in sort of dark. Remember to press down lightly at home, but I did that so you could see exactly the shape that I was making. Now, the feet are funny shaped. They almost look like eggs, but they don't. I don't know. It's hard to explain. You're just going to have to follow along with me. The easiest way to do it is you're going to start off by doing what looks like a letter C here and what looks like the letter C here, okay, on both sides. All right, you're going to go back to the front and do the same thing, a letter C here and what looks like the letter C here. And once you have those two things, we're going to actually make a straight line coming back for both of them, just like that. Two straight lines, and then this comes out at a slight angle connecting to the rest of the foot. There you go. You have his feet. The shapes for the lines for the toes are really simple. You're just going to draw these little lines coming up into the feet like that, and also add one in the back here, of course, here. And then for his tail is really simple. Just a line coming up, back down. There's a little bit of width in there. See what I mean? Gets thinner as it goes up. And now we've saved something for the end, and that's going to be the tongue. Now, Odie's tongue actually comes out at a shape that looks like this. So we're going to start right here in the mouth, and we're going to draw two lines coming out like this. One here, and we're going to do another here. Now these two lines will form the tongue, so the tongue will actually come out and down, back up. See? So it goes, wraps around and comes up and back in. So that forms his tongue. And then there's a division up here at the top that we're going to draw. And then, of course, we want to add in this the little spit from the dog and his tongue a wagon, okay? Be sure and add those in. And you can even put a little pool at the bottom. It's sort of gross, whatever, but the comics that do this a lot. Maybe he's hungry. We'll add those in at the bottom just like that, okay? These lines just represent like light reflecting off of the liquid of the spit at the bottom. So it's kind of weird saying draw some spit, but hey, dogs have a lot of slobber. If you have a dog, you know what I mean. And Odie certainly has a lot of slobber if you ever looked at a Garfield comic, okay? So now what I'm doing is I'm going back over my lines here. I noticed that the ears that I made are just a little too small, so I may increase the size of those a little bit. May do that on both sides like that right there. Now, once we have everything penciled in, as we do now, what we're going to do, we got a spot, though, I forgot. He's got a little spot on his back of his belly there, right there. So now what we can do after we have all those things is we can ink our piece. Now, hopefully what you've done at home is that you've pushed down sort of lightly. And like I said earlier, you're going to need a marker for this. What you're going to do is you trace over your lines now, okay? You're just simply tracing over the lines that you've created. We're going to erase all of these pencil lines here in a little bit. So all those lines that you've used to draw the circles and the ovals and all of these things are going to disappear. We want to wait till our ink dries before we do that. But we want to go ahead now and start tracing. Now, you want to be very careful here on what lines you trace, and it's kind of self-explanatory a little bit when you start doing it. For instance, I know I'm not going to trace this line going straight down below the nose, because that line was used to guide me, to give me the center of the dog's face, okay? I do know that I'm going to trace the lines like the division of his eyes here, going around the top, and the lines that are important to the drawing that will give us our finished piece, okay? I've seen a lot of students, and I've mentioned this a few times, try to start drawing something free-handed, and it's really hard sometimes to do that. It's just better to use these examples to lead by, okay? And I hope we're going to have time to do one more dog for you today. We're going to have to speed draw through that one, I'm afraid. We may have to speed draw through two, but as I'm drawing and as you're watching me speed draw, it's really important that you remember that each one of the things that you're seeing me do on those steps are exactly the same things that I've done here to draw this. And if you watch really close, you'll see me draw a circle, and then you'll see me draw lines to help guide me, ovals. You know what I used to do? I used to squint my eyes. I would look at a drawing. A drawing or whatever it is I was wanting to draw, and I would squint my eyes. And I still do this sometimes, really. The reason I do that, though, is because when you squint your eyes at something, you see only the general shapes of it. You see, like, you know, the circles, the squares, and things like that. Just try it. Just whatever it is you want to draw at home. Maybe you're having a hard time drawing a certain cartoon character that you really like a lot. Try to just look at it, squint your eyes, and draw those general shapes very lightly on a piece of paper. What happens is this serves as a building block. Almost like you're crafting, you're drawing out of clay or something, right? So you have the general shapes you need, and then you start to add detail into those shapes. That's exactly how the professionals do it. Whether you're working on a tablet or working at home on ink and pen or whatever it is that you're doing, all the professionals start out with these general shapes that they use, okay? So it's really important for you to have that framework to go by. Once you've drawn a certain character 100 times or 1,000 times, you don't really need to start using those shapes as much. But when you're learning how to draw something for the first time, yeah, it's really important to do that. So now what I'm doing is just finishing sketching out the drawing. That's all I'm doing now. These are the lines I talked about to symbolize water earlier. Okay, I may put a little bit of shadow in underneath him here, like that. And now you have your inking finished. We'll let this dry for a little bit, and then we'll come back to it as we do our fast sketch. And you'll see me erase all of this at the end. So be sure and watch that at the main end of our show today. After the speed drawing, me erasing all of these different images that I've drawn for you so you can see what it looks like once it's what we call polished up and cleaned up, okay? All right, so I hope you're ready for the speed drawing. We're going to be doing two dogs today, actually. Like I said, Courage the Cowardly Dog and a Hound Dog in speed drawing. So I hope you enjoy that. Try to stay with me during the speed drawing. It may be a little fast for you, but for some, I bet you have no trouble at all, okay? All right, so we're going to jump right into that. And like I said, using the same method we used to create our Odie, we're going to be doing the other two drawings, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and get started on the next two. So that's the speed drawing. We've penciled, inked, and now we've let the ink allow to dry, and we can start the process of actually erasing at this point. Hope you've been able to follow along with me. And as you can see, each cartoon dog that we've completed today have been established and finished up using the circle method. And the circle method really is a beneficial tool for young artists. It allows artists to be able to see a general shape of a drawing, you know, before they're actually starting to put in the detail and stuff. So what we're going to do now is actually erase on some of these so you can see what the finished piece looks like. And this is the most exciting part for me anyway, because you get rid of all those lines and then what's left is just the ink. So we can erase now. And I use this thick eraser. It's a block eraser that you can get. They sell them for various prices, really cheap too, usually some of them. At any store carrying art supplies in your area. Really important though not to buy one that's too cheap, because what happens is you'll spend a lot of time on a drawing and the eraser, instead of actually picking up the surface medium that you want to pull, what I mean by that is, like, instead of being able to erase the graphite off the page, it'll actually leave lines on your page, which you don't want that after spending a ton amount of time on something, getting it to look the way you want it to, and then have it messed up by trying to erase. So that's something to keep in mind. Usually I think, you know, between $1, $1.50 sometimes even, for a really good kneaded eraser. But you know, you can get them fairly cheap. If you don't have a kneaded eraser, don't worry. All you really need at home is to have your pencil eraser. Now, if you notice, while I was actually penciling this hound dog here, I used a blue pencil, and I wanted to do that because sometimes that helps me. Black and gray are very close together, of course, and when I have to press down really hard so you can see the general shape that I'm doing when I do the circles at home on your screen, what happens is the black and the gray mix, and then sometimes it's hard for me to either see the line I wanted to use or you know, erase the line properly even as well. So I use blue on this one. The interesting thing about a blue leaded pencil when you're drawing with it is that it actually is invisible whenever you make a scan or a copy of it using a black and white setting on a scanner. So if I were to go and to scan this image here using the blue photo, non-photo lens pencil that I used, and I scanned it in black and white, all the blue would disappear. So in fact, I wouldn't even have to erase that before sending this off production. Now, I work for a lot of companies too when I use color, and so I have to scan and send images to publishing companies. And when that happens, I like to be able to have the entire surface as visible as possible. This only applies to cartooning, of course. It has nothing to do with the illustration whenever we're scanning in stuff like this, okay? The one thing that it does apply to with the illustration is if I was going to go on from here and color this actually using a software like Photoshop or Animate Studio or something along those lines, you can actually scan this into as a black line image, as we call it, with just the artwork into the computer, and then you would be able to color underneath it. What I mean underneath it is that these black lines will be what's called a layer, and all the white around here would go away and vanish, and you could actually color underneath. A lot of early animation cells, they called them animation cells, and what those are is a clear piece of plastic with the drawing on the top. And so when artists would go in to paint that one cell that makes up one frame of an animation, they would paint it on the back of the image itself. Really cool process. It's one that's almost went away completely now, but now we use mostly all digital. So I missed a couple of the little lines here when I was inking earlier. I want to be sure and include those. I hope you're able to follow along with me today. I hope you had a good time doing it and everything. As you can see, you could draw just about anything you want using this method. And now we've cleaned up the pieces. You can see how they look. They've went from pencil line, rough circles, shapes, ovals, to now it looks like cartoon characters. Believe it or not, all your favorite cartoon characters are actually created and started using this method, from the original design to the finished piece. So use this method often. Use it to create your own characters. Use your own storylines. Have character backgrounds, and do everything that you can to enhance your ideas and your arts and your creations. And we want to see those creations. So if you have something at home and you'd like to send it here to the hauler and to Pike TV, and so we could see it and show it, we'd love to. So go to thehauler.org and look for what's called the Art Hauler, and go ahead and send us your work so we can promote that and show it to all of our viewing audience, okay? Before we go today, I want to be sure and encourage you to draw as much as possible. If you're generally interested in this and you like creating and drawing, draw as much as possible. Go on YouTube. If you have problem drawing hands, actually search for videos on how to draw hands. Today we focused on dogs, and you know, dogs are fun to draw, and they're all throughout, you know, different illustrations, cartooning, and comics. But you could search for anything online and find out how to actually draw it. So I encourage you to do that. Okay. Please tune in again for our next show. We thank Pike TV for hosting us and making this possible. We thank The Hauler and The Hauler Studio for producing this at the University of Pikeville. So I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoy what we're doing here, okay? Thanks so much, and until next time, keep drawing.